Good morning and welcome to Williams Dog Training Company. We're here today with Fred and Pacha Mama, and what we're going to be demonstrating for you today is Pacha Mama's ability to understand and respond to her obedience commands, the corrections and motivations that we use while we're working with her, and the training equipment that we're using. Fred is using a regular 6-foot training leash, and he keeps the bulk of that leash folded neatly in his right hand, leaving his left hand free then to give the correction. And the correction that we give is a tug and release on the training collar, which is the second piece of equipment that we're using. Pacha Mama has been fitted with her own personal training collar, and we will be sure to show you how to properly put that collar on and use it during your one-on-one lesson. Now, as you can see, Pacha Mama is sitting very nicely on Fred's left-hand side, which is where all of our obedience training takes place. The first command that they're going to demonstrate for you is heeling, and heeling is proper walking on a leash. Fred and Pacha Mama take off doing that now, and the command that you're going to give is Pacha Mama heel, and you're going to simply start walking, and she should fall in line nicely, walking nicely right there at your left heel position. She should not be lagging behind so that you have to pull her on the leash, nor should she be lunging ahead and pulling you on that leash. Also incorporated into our heeling exercise is an automatic sit, which you just saw occur right there. So anytime that you're out walking with her and you stop, she should sit nicely right there at your left heel position. Good girl. The next command they're going to demonstrate for you is the stay command, and the stay command is both a hand and a voice command. You're going to use the open flat of your left palm an inch or so in front of her muzzle, and the one word command to stay. Then walk out to the end of your training leash. Now she should remain seated in this position throughout the entire command and should not move. This is a great command to practice frequently throughout your day to help build up her ability to stay for longer periods of time. When you're practicing at home, you want to start at 1 minute, and you'll slowly increase your intervals up over time, working up to 3 minutes with the long sit stay. Now when Fred returns back, he's going to walk all the way around counterclockwise, returning back to heel position. She did a fabulous job. You see that he bends down and gives her a little pat on the head there. It is important to remember that when you're working Pacha Mama through her commands and she's completing them successfully, you let her know so by giving her either physical praise or verbal praise. You can pet her, let her know she did a good job though. And they're running through their heel sit and stay again. Open flat in front of her muzzle. The command is stay up at the end of the leash. Now this time, instead of returning back to heel position, they're going to demonstrate the recall or the come on command. You're going to use her name to call her in. She should come directly in front of you and sit nicely.
No, she
didn't sit, so Fred gave her a tug and release on the training collar, but the first words out of his mouth were no, followed by the correction, and repeated the command where she sat nicely. Heel her around the back of you, returning her to her left-hand your left-hand side, where she should again sit nicely. And Fred's going to demonstrate that for you again. Leave her in a sit-stay, walk out to the end of your leash. Give her a few seconds to hold her sit-stay. Call her, and using her name, you can guide her to come directly in front of you by using your leash. You saw that time she came in and sat nicely right away, very well done. Heels around the back of Fred, returning to his left-hand side, sitting nicely. She didn't sit nicely again. So it gave a little tug and release. Again, make sure you follow through. She has to follow through with her commands. Now when she first comes home, you want to make sure that you're practicing all of your commands, both indoors as well as outdoors, generalizing them throughout the day. And at first, when you're practicing your commands, try to pick an area with no distractions, and you'll slowly incorporate the amount of distractions into your training sessions over time. Now, the next command they're going to demonstrate for you is the down from a heel position. Again, you're going to use the open flat of your left palm, but this time straight down towards the ground and the one word command to down. Then give the stay command and walk out to the end of your leash, same that you did with the sit stay. Now, with the down stay, again, make sure that you practice this practicing this command frequently throughout your day to help build up her ability to downstay for longer periods of time. Again, she should remain laying down in this position and should not move from this position. And when you're practicing at home, you start at 3 minutes, increasing your intervals, working up to 5 minutes. Good job. And we'll demonstrate that again. As I mentioned earlier, you want to make sure that you're incorporating your commands into your everyday activities and practicing them with her. But at least for the first 2 to 4 weeks after she comes home, you want to make sure that you are setting aside about 10 to 15 minutes every day to work her in a formal obedience session such as this video here. You can put it on and follow along at first, and then you can kind of create your own routine so that you're working her through her commands at least 10 to 15 minutes in a session every day. And they're going to demonstrate the recall or the come command from the down position now. Good girl.
No, sit.
Good girl. You heard in Fred's voice, he had a nice firm no. You want to make sure that when you are correcting her, if need be, you're using a nice firm tone to let her know that that's inappropriate, followed by a tug and release in the training collar if need be. And again, this is everything that we will go over with you during your one-on-one lesson.
Stay.
On her graduation. Now Fred's leaving her in a sit stay and walking out to the end of the leash to demonstrate the down from a distance. You're going to use your right hand from the end of the leash to give her the down command.
Down.
Good job. Now we have started to incorporate some off-leash into her training in our new indoor facility, where we're able to drop the leash and increase the distance on our sit stay as well as our down stay. Fred's demonstrating this for you now. Now this is something that you will be able to work up working with her, but again, you want to make sure that you're working her through her commands using her leash and her collar, and she's completing those commands for you 100% of the time and obeying before you decide to drop the leash and increase your distance. Fred's going to return back now. She's a good girl, remaining still there. Good girl. We've demonstrated for you today all the obedience commands that Pacha Mama has learned here at school. It's been a pleasure working with her, and we thank you again for choosing Williams Dog Training Company as your personal dog trainer.